So now we are in a place where the regeneration took place about 4 years ago, right? Can you tell me a little bit what's going on here after that?
These spruces here are already like some maybe 1 meter long, depending a little bit on the seeding where it is located. And also, as you can see, so it's not only spruces that are growing here, but we have like a lot of different tree species over here already. For example, we have rowan here behind me. Then we also have aspen and birch growing here naturally. So they were not regenerated like by hand. And yeah, a lot of different kind of like there's like after the regeneration felling 4 years, so you can definitely see that it's not like an open place anymore, but there are like a lot of different kind of plants here. For example, what is quite mentionable at the moment that for the multiple use of our forest, that there has been like a really good party for the pollinators in the springtime, and now like in the late summer, so we will get like a huge amount of raspberries to be eaten right here.
So you could call this a pollinator paradise, I suppose.
Yeah, in the springtime, yes.
Yeah. So now we are in a young forest. These trees are about 8 years old or so. What has happened here so far?
Okay, yeah, you're right. This is like an 8 year old, or these spruces have been here for 8 years. And before that, there was like a regeneration felling, soil preparation, inverting the soil, and then the spruces have been planted. And as you can see, so these 8 year old trees, they have grown quite rapidly lately. And as you can see, so the birches behind us, so they are growing even more rapidly than the spruces here. It's interesting to see how the sort of like the competition between different trees here is affecting the growth.
And it's still, when this side is being cleared, I can still see quite a lot of birch and other trees than spruce. I suppose that's one of the important features, to leave all kinds of trees, even in a thinning site.
Oh, yes. We know that like the composition of different tree species is quite important for the biodiversity. And when we do the clearing, or when we do the thinning, tending, so we only like clear those areas or those trees which are negatively affecting the growth of the spruce that we have chosen to be like a large tree in the future.
Mm-hmm. So more species means more biodiversity in the forest.
Yeah, basically.
It's quite simple. Yeah. All right. So what will happen next here?
I guess like we will need a tending maybe in 5 years to give more space to the spruces. And maybe 20 years from now, so there will be the first thinning, which is the first commercial thinning. So it means like the forest owner gets some income from the felling.
And in that first commercial, you mean that then the wood that is taken out, it's used commercially in the pulp process, I suppose. It's not very thick logwood yet.
Yeah,
in the first thinning.
Completely right. Yeah. So yes, the trees are not that large in diameter just yet, but the idea is to give space for the rest of the trees to go wider and wider. And the smaller trees which are taken away from the forest, so they are produced to pulp and then of course to paper and board.
Mm-hmm. And bioenergy, I suppose.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
All right. Thank you.